So what about the children?
Just these fake little hooks that they put on. You know, it's just a fake little hook. But this other fake little hook that they put on is, look, we're designing all of this. We know what we're doing. You terrible people want to use this stuff. So finally, we have to design some things. But we're concerned that you're going to damage your brain. Now, I look at the architecture, the rules, the hypocrisies. I go, your brain is already damaged. What are you talking about? I'm not emulating your way of thinking. This is ridiculous. I mean, this is the funny part to me. They're worried about your brain. And who could? I don't even think I could come up with a series of laws so screwed up if I tried to sit down and come up with a series of laws so screwed up. It's amazing to me.
Well, you know, they put in positions of authority in the file were incarcerators. Hmm. Incarcerators. Yeah. People who were locking us up were put in charge of the file. Okay?
Mm-hmm.
That says everything I need to hear right there. Okay. The guys who are locking us up are in charge of the file. And you look at Ernie Eves, former premier of this province.
Let's go there.
He's the head of the biggest pot company in Jamaica. The former deputy commissioner, the RCMP, the head of another pot company. I mean, I did a tour with the RCMP once, and I come from a position of legalizing all drugs.
Right.
Because, you know, illegalized and making drugs illegal and vilifying the weakest among us is a bad idea. And until we legalize all drugs, listen, there are only two ways people get drugs, legally or illegally. And you've seen what the way that we've handled it has worked. We've built prisons and we've filled them up with millions of people. So obviously that's not the right way. So let's turn it over to people who are actually health experts who can help people. I have not met an addict who wants to be one when they get there.
Mm-hmm.
So we need to help people, not vilify them, not isolate them, not separate them from us. We need to help them back in. And, you know, we don't have governments that are interested in that, but we have governments that are interested in punishing the weakest among us.
Yeah, I think it's really not about changing the mind of the government. It's about making the truth and the facts available and aware to anybody that can challenge the government, because they only get away with this stuff because most people don't know about it.
Most
I had people telling me
it.
I'm sure you had people coming up to you, because I had this. They know you're got some kind of history with cannabis, like they do with me when if they know me. And they come up and they've been saying things like, wow, hey, October 17, you must be excited, eh? You must be happy. It's finally going to be legal. And they have no idea the exact import of their words. The word legal, what does it mean? Why would I be happy that something really fucked up is about to be born? Mm-hmm. You know, I look at this legislation of if the legislation were perfect and you compared it to architecture, those are some pretty fine plans there, and the building's going to be wonderful and grand. But they've just delivered shit mm-hmm. from Home Depot. Here's some 2x4s, here's some nails. This is what it is. Make do. We'll fix it as we go.
And then you see, you go to a place like Newfoundland, the government is only letting the retailers make 8%.
Profit?
Yeah. That's all they're allowed to make on the pot.
How do they figure they're going to manage to control
that? You know
what?
How does a retailer make it making 8%? I don't know.
Why would you
want
to do
that? Most retailers I know are 50-50. They make half, they pay half. You know, I buy a product for 50 cents, I sell it for a dollar. Here you buy a product for a dollar, you sell it for $1.08.
Yeah, that's ridiculous.
So the government wants all the money.
Isn't it funny, too?
All the money. They want all the money.
They go on these tours. They'll do speaking town hall events in their province and across the country. Kathleen Wynne did one here. And one of their constant politician laments is that they're examining the landscape and they're open for suggestions to find out ways to drum up the economy. And Kathleen Wynne and Justin Trudeau have taken the economy. Imagine if we had shops popping up here and there. Hey, say your weed's not as good. Well, you're going out of business. My weed's better. I'm doing okay. Like that thing, you know, let's do that.
Yeah, open market.
And, you know, democracy. Mm-hmm. You know, the money you say you need that you don't have right now for all kinds of things. I don't know what the tax income right now is at in Colorado, but better than here on it. And they just don't exercise any of these options while they tell you this stuff. And that's fake, you know, about the kids and we can't advertise it. But we will advertise it to the people that are the multimillionaires we already made the deals with.
Right.
What do you know about Ernie Eves? I find it amazing that a guy who was a conservative premier, he was the actual finance minister of this province and then became the premier later on after Harris.
another miserable character.
Yeah, but a big star on the blue team, right?
Oh,
and,
yeah.
And so he goes down to Jamaica.
Very miserable guy. Blame poverty on the poor.
Opens up a cannabis or is the head of some kind of... So fill me
largest
in here. What do you know about
cannabis company in Jamaica. I don't know much about it other than that's that. And, you know, just the fact that it is that... look at John Boehner, the former Speaker of the House in the United States, who said good people don't smoke marijuana.
He was an alcoholic.
He owns a bar, smokes cigarettes, chain smoker. So here's a guy who had all kinds of bad things to say about pot, is now the chairman of a Michigan pot company.
Is that right?
And his word was, I've had a change of heart. No, you had a change of wallet. Let's tell the truth about this. You have a change of heart. You got money, and that's how
that's
you change
all it is.
Your position.
Like
he
Julian Fantino, the cop, who's at this...
Another one. Paid, a paid shill for the government's pot legislation.
I can't believe that there may be someone now, only just now beginning to get the chance to rebuild their life that was taken from them by Julian's arrest back in the day, and they're just kind of getting out of jail and trying to figure things out maybe now while this guy rolls around like a pig in a trough with our dollars.
I got friends who are still in prison for pot who got 75 years for pot that didn't exist. Conspiracy.
What do you mean it didn't exist?
Conspiracy charge.
Oh, I see.
No pot.
Wow.
And they're never getting out. Basically, they're going to die there. There are a lot of people in the United States who are in prison for pot who are going to die there.
God, that's
and
unreal.
That's just the way it is. See, these people, back when I got sentenced to 10 years, I thought that was a huge sentence in 91. Well, when I got there, I realized, gee, it was actually a tiny sentence.
Did
I was
you
one
do
of the
full 10?
Lucky guys. No, I didn't. I got transferred to Canada and they let me out. The people in the U.S. are just doing thrilling time for pot, and you know many of them will die in there because they were sentenced under the new law, and the new law means you serve 8.5 days of every 10 days you were sentenced.
Wow.
So there's no more parole or.
It is monstrous. I can't even believe it. I mean, when I started to realize, based on my reading and understanding things and you know studying the politicians that were involved, I thought this thing is going to be so bad, and I'm sitting in front of it now. I was dead right about it, but I was paying attention. It's not like I'm a genius. I don't think most people pay attention to it, you know, whereas my life depended on it, so I was very much on point, you know.
Yeah, and you know, in the U.S. if you were ever charged, there was no winning. One of my friends in there, he got charged with a bunch of other guys, and they all pleaded out and got 5 years. He decided to challenge it, and because he challenged it, he got 35.
Wow.
And, you know, you got to realize in the U.S., when you're charged, 99%+ of federal charges end up in convictions.
Sure.
And most of them are negotiated convictions, plea agreements.
Yeah.
Because they threaten you with a million things, so you're just glad to accept one and run away.
Wow. Let's go back to prison for a second, because I want to talk about